Today, talking to Lesley Clarke, and we're going to cast our minds back to 1953 and the Queen's coronation. Lesley, whereabouts were you living in 1953?
Westbury Road.
Oh, up Stocking Ford.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And obviously, all the excitement of a coronation had been building up for 12 months, really, since the King died.
Yeah.
So, where was the... Did you have a street party?
No, we didn't have an actual street party in Westbury Road. We had it up at the White Lion in Croft Road, which was then run by Minnie Davenport. And her daughter, Diane, was in my class at school. And the day the Queen was crowned, I was 5 that year.
Yeah.
My mum couldn't afford the material for a dress for me. So she bought some red, white and blue crepe paper and she made a crinoline out of it, sewed it, stitched it all together, and I had a bonnet to match and a muff, you know, to keep your hands warm.
Yeah.
And I looked like a walking Union Jack.
Uh-huh.
And we went up to the pub, and in that day, The song was, I think it was a Donald Pierce song, and I remember it as "She Rides in a Golden Coach." Might be wrong about the title of it, but I learnt that song off by heart. And what I did was, when we got into the pub, there was the pianist was Vonnie Claridge, who lived just up from me in Westbury Road, and she was playing the piano, and I stood on an old lady's lap and I sang "She Rides in a Golden Coach." They had a whip round for me, and I got that much money that I'd earned more singing that song than my dad did in a week. I got pennies and halfpennies and shillings, tanners, threepences, and all the rest of it. And of course, what I did was, we lived next door to a shop. So that's where all that money went.
Oh, so the shopkeeper had a good week.
Oh, yeah.
So did you watch the coronation on the television?
Yes.
At the pub, or...?
I think it was at the pub.
Yeah.
I can remember seeing the coronation, yeah.
Yeah, because, I mean, there must have been so much red, white and blue decorations, all the houses and...
Oh, yeah.
All, you know, I think every street had got some sort of red, white and blue. So you was at the White Lion, and so did the White Lion put on a buffet or?
Well, it was mostly for kids, you know, jellies and cakes and things like that. Whatever they could afford to do at the time, because I mean, bearing in mind, we'd just come out of rationing, hadn't we?
Yes. Yeah.
So, but I'm not kidding. I can remember that and the money that I had.
Yeah. And was there a children's fancy dress competition or anything?
I can't remember that. No.
I know some places even had a coronation queen, and they chose a little girl to play the role of the queen as well. I've seen some photographs like that. But I mean, it was, you know, Britain had been through some dark years because of World War II, which had only finished 8 years previous, and a lot of parts of the UK were still rebuilding from bomb damage.
Yeah.
So this coronation came along sooner than expected, obviously, because of the King's health. I mean, the Queen was only 23, I think it was, when she was crowned. Very young Queen. And it offered some hope and lifted people's spirits.
Yes, it did.
You know, and people were singing and making merry. Mm. And as you say, there was parties here, there and everywhere, up and down the country.
Yeah.
But it's a nice memory to look back on.
Oh, it is. It is.
And I think if you witness one coronation in your lifetime, you're lucky.
Yeah.
And to witness two is extremely rare.
It is, yeah.
And God bless her, the Queen's done a few good years.
Yeah. Well, she'll be the longest reigning monarch.
September 2015, she becomes Britain's longest reigning monarch. But it's been brilliant talking to you and remembering the Queen's coronation. And if you've got any memories that you'd like to talk about, if you can remember the Queen's coronation, VE Day celebrations in Nuneaton, please contact us via our website at www.nuneatonmemories.co.uk.